I come from a small family. My grandma is from Marito, and my grandpa is from Acanya. I actually don't ever remember my parents being together, but my parents divorced when I was 3. We weren't, by any stretch of the imagination, well-to-do or even comfortable. I remember that it was a struggle, paycheck to paycheck. My dad, for a long time, was paying child support for my two older siblings, Tammy and Brian. I love them very much, and they did a lot to raise me as well. And my dad was just working really, really hard to support us. And later in life, when I was a young adult, I remember it was after the Unpinko cowboy election. I got involved in the Unpinko cowboy election, and we lost the primary. And then the Camacho Moylan people came over, and they were recruiting, you know, everybody. You know, they did a good job of talking to everybody. In 2009, I left the Camacho administration, and strangest thing, one day after I resigned, I get a phone call and a voice message from a Senator Eddie Calvo as I'm driving over to the veterinary clinic here in Aspen. It's a veterinary clinic. And I'm like, wow, Senator Calvo's called me. And he says, yeah, can you give me a call? I just want to chat with you. And I'm like, wow, what's this about? And then just coincidentally, I go in, and for the first time out of all the years I'm going to Dr. Silk, there's Senator Ray Tenorio with his dog. And he says, hey, I'm running with Senator Calvo. Senator Calvo's running for governor. I'm running for lieutenant governor. You know, we haven't announced it, but I heard you left the governor's office. Can you join our campaign? You know, typical, you know, style of Ray Tenorio is just go right in. And what could I say? I said, well, that's great. You know, I really like Senator Calvo. I worked on his Unpinko Calvo campaign, and I had no idea the role that I was given or just how significant it was. I didn't realize this until there was this day that we had to go to the Guam Young Professionals, and they asked me to introduce the governor. And I was flipping out because I don't do well in front of crowds. I don't do well in front of the camera. And I turned to the governor because he noticed my trepidation. I said, you know, governor, I'm not really sure what I'm doing here because I don't really do well in front of people. And I'm probably not gonna do well in front of my peers, and people don't know who I am, and I don't do speeches. And he turns to me, he's got this look in his eyes. Wait a minute, you're the director of communications, and you don't like cameras, you don't do well in front of people, and you can't do speeches. And he says to me, there's a reason I chose you. You're the director of communications. Don't worry about it, bud. And I took to the stage and I introduced him, and there was a burst of confidence that I had. It was that day that I realized that this guy, who was the governor of Guam, who didn't care about anything except that I could contribute and that I shared some values with him. And when he brought that confidence out of me that day, it was an emotional task, because in politics, you had to be somebody. You had to have the right last name. You had to come from a social circle. They had to see you at the red balls and the galas, and you had to have the right clothes. You have to donate money and be at the fundraisers, and you have to talk the right way and be on the news, and people have to recognize who you are. And I'm none of that. I don't come from a politically popular family. I don't come from politics. My family doesn't have lots of money. I'm gay. I don't have my own children. You know, I have my own baggage. I have my own faults. And this guy didn't care about any of that. And where I would have been a nobody to somebody else's administration, I am someone to his. And in his vision, people like me, and other people who don't feel that they've been given a chance to succeed, to shine, we mean something to this man. And if that can happen for another 4 years, then I'll tell you that is that's something pretty special. Every day I wake up before the sun rises and I'm excited to go to work for Guam. And every night I go to bed with a clear conscience, knowing I was part of a movement that made Guam a better place. I want kids to grow up having much more than I ever had. I want them to have confidence in themselves, to believe in themselves and in the greatness of our people. This is what Governor Calvo is building for them and for all of us. Eddie Calvo gives me the confidence to say, I'm Troy Torres, and I'm the Director of Communications.